A world away from the city, 1,200 feet above sea level, 2,000 acres of rugged Peak District moors surround Chatsworth's valley. This harshest of environments is home to 50 head of hardy cattle who live wild, free to roam a primordial landscape.
Tracking down the livestock is quite tricky. It can easily take up almost the day.
Every day, Assistant Farms Manager Jack must check the welfare of the herd.
So today we've got two pairs of eyes. So it's David Howlett, the farm manager, ahead of us.
But the one day Jack asks his boss to give him a hand, the cattle decide to make his job look ridiculously easy.
It takes hours to find them every day.
The choice of these Hebridean cattle is highly strategic.
These are Ling cattle off the Isle of Ling in Scotland. And on this moor, there were certain areas that were coming very sort of undergrazed and overgrown with certain types of grass. So we introduced this cattle project about 2 years ago because they're a hardy breed. They'll live all year quite happily off of the stuff behind us.
David and Jack have come up with a 21st century solution to the age-old problem of finding cattle lost on the moor.
This device here is a GPS tracking collar, so it releases a signal every 15 minutes, and then we can track these collars on an app and go straight to where they are instead of spending several hours looking for the cattle. And this is the first time we've ever used them, so they kind of look like a necklace for a cow. They're quite a fashionable piece of kit, really.
But how do you fit high-tech necklaces to a wild herd of half-ton cattle? All with minds of their own.
A tractor reverses a metal cage into position.
The team have had to haul a portable cattle corral called a crush up to the high moor.
Running some cattle into the handling system, and then we're going to run them into the crush where we can contain the animals and prevent them injuring themselves or injuring us.
Steady. Go on, you've only got one way. Go on.
A cow's in the crush.
Yeah.
I'm pretty certain tracker stays on that side.
Jack, I think, would you be better off putting it at the back of it, through here?
Yeah. There's a counterweight in the middle.
Yeah.
The tracker number is AN054. One down, four to go. I think they're a bit startled, but they'll get used to it over time. A bit like when you give your girlfriend a new necklace or something. She runs around for a bit, wanting to look at it and show it off to everyone, and then she gets used to it.
I'm not going to comment.
But with only five collars between the herd, Jack's plan faces a fundamental flaw.
The risk we've got to take if those five cows stay together and the rest of them disappear. By this time tomorrow, we'll know what's happened.
A very different sort of check is underway up on Eastmoor, where Jack's searching for the Ling cattle using their high-tech new trackers.
It's a pretty typical autumnal day in Derbyshire. It's raining and windy, and sometimes it's quite tricky to locate the cattle.
Jack hopes the trackers app will lead him directly to the cattle.
So at the minute, here's our location on the app. The cows are somewhere in this area. If I walk out onto the moor, we should be able to track half of the group. Hopefully going to go straight to the location that the cows are, and I can carry on with my day. Fingers crossed, and not just collars in the middle of the moor. I can see a couple of them up ahead.
The cattle may be hard to spot against the heather backdrop, but the app leads Jack straight to them.
Afternoon, girls. Well, they're looking well. I can't see any issues at all with them. Obviously, this is the heifer that's had the collar on. It doesn't look too tight. The animal still looks happy. These Ling heifers, they really do thrive in these conditions. Look a bit soggy and a bit damp on a day like today. They're not bothered at all by the weather.
By following the cow's movements, Jack can also track the impact they have on the environment.
The graze this heather and bracken and all this old shrub, and in return they produce muck, which improves the biodiversity of the habitat in this area. So I can use the information on our tracking app, and then over a long period of time, we can see how they've improved the biodiversity. So it's a bit of a learning curve for us as well as a learning curve for the cattle, but so far, so good. Got quite a lot on, so I'll go and be on with the rest of the day.